Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more. As a Harvard economist points out, I think we have really met a once-in-a-generation take-this-job-and-shove-it moment. It's not like we don't have enough problems here in the United States. Supply chain, inflation, heating and gas costs are astronomical. We're looking at political instability, infighting, a debt ceiling, and now the Great Resignation? Are people really quitting their jobs? Does anyone want to work anymore? According to data, we've hit an all-time high in job availability. Job openings hover near all-time highs as Great Resignation shows little sign of easing. Employers recently posted 11 million job openings. So there are a lot of jobs available, but people aren't taking them. Not only are they not taking the jobs that are opened, they're quitting their existing jobs. In September, we had 4.4 million quits. In October, 4.2 million quits. This is tremendous. The Great Resignation is on. So are workers going to return to work? The data shows that many Americans are simply not interested in returning to the traditional 9-to-5 job. During the economic shutdowns, we laid off so many people that they found alternate ways to make money. The new gig opportunities out there have changed the economy and the look of the workforce. Many Americans are finding that they can earn money on their own. The result is, yes, 11 million job openings. And the ultimate result means that workers are not where we need them to be. When you go to a restaurant, you experience slower service. In all service jobs out there, when we need help, the service is slower. As millions and millions of Americans continue to quit their jobs, we don't have enough people, and that is creating supply chain issues. We don't have truck drivers, and when we do have drivers, we don't have people there to unload the trucks. This is affecting inflation. The inflation numbers are coming in soon. On a year-to-year basis, the CPI is expected to accelerate to 6.7% clip versus October's 6.2% annual rise. And I expect inflation to be closer to a staggering 7% for November. And in order for companies to even keep people at work and possibly attract new people, companies plan big raises for workers in 2022. Conference Board report says companies have budgeted more money for pay increases than at any point since 2008. One of the driving forces of inflation is the cost of labor. As millions and millions of jobs are being unfilled and employers have to attract and keep people with higher wages, these are getting baked into the cost of your goods and services, meaning you're paying higher prices, ultimately meaning more and more inflation. Will the labor force go back to work? This is definitely a story that we will keep track of. So subscribe to our channel for more updates.